Learn how to accelerate Oracle migrations to Azure SQL with a new extension available in Azure Data Studio. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Neel, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Neel, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hi, Anna. Hi, I'm Neel. I'm a program manager, and I focus in the database migration space, primarily focus on the heterogeneous migration, which is any non-Microsoft platform like Oracle and migrating to SQL or Postgres and so on. So that's pretty much the charter I kind of manage at this point.
Awesome. Cool. So you seem like the perfect person to have on the show to talk to us about Oracle migrations and some new capabilities in Azure Data Studio itself. Can you just tell us a little bit about these new capabilities?
Sure. Before that, I'll just give a quick background. So when we reached out to a lot of enterprise customers and partners, a few of the challenges today they have when they're migrating their Oracle to Azure is to do a quick pre-assessment to understand the feasibility and what is the right target if they are moving to Azure. And also, when they move to Azure, what might be the effort, like a very high-level effort, which is required to do the schema conversion and assessment. Taking this feedback, what we decided, like, let's go ahead and unblock the scenarios for our partners and customers. And we decided to create a single place of experience in the Azure Data Studio, where we have built our new Oracle assessment experience where users can connect to Oracle from Azure Data Studio, which they're very, like Azure Data Studio, most of our kind of DBAs and developers, they're quite familiar. So we wanted to reuse the existing platform. And there they can connect to the existing Oracle workload, do a quick shallow discovery of their Oracle, like the schemas, the tables, the views. And based on that, we give a quick t-shirt size recommendation, like which workload is simple, which is complex, and what are the feature compatibilities if they're trying to migrate, let's say, for example, partitioning, then how the feature parity is between Oracle and SQL. So we are trying to make the life easy for our customers to make those initial kind of assessment done in a much more holistic way.
Awesome. Cool. I'd love to take a look if you have something for us.
Yes, I have a quick demo for this. So give me a couple of seconds and let me show the new experience in Azure Data Studio. So you see that I'm connected to the Azure Data Studio and I have an Oracle instance on the left. So you can connect to Oracle from Azure Data Studio. And then you can right-click and click on Manage. So when you click on Manage, what you see is this new experience called Oracle Assessment. The first, if you see that there's a quick snapshot of what are my last five assessments, and you can see that I have run five assessments, four success, and one failure. So you get a quick summary, what are the various assessments you might have run for this given server. And if you want to start an assessment, just click on Run New Assessment. So when you do run new assessment, you need to provide a name. So I say demo X. And then what you do is you select a SQL as a target right now. But in future, we plan to add many other targets. And we are just constantly looking for feedback, which are the suitable targets for Oracle kind of workload. But to begin with, we start with SQL. The scale factor is when we collect the performance data, for example, you are running the data collection today, but your peak load is sometime maybe during the month of December, November. So you kind of change the scale factor and say, hey, my scale factor might be 2x or 1.5x. So my peak load is more than current test performance data collection scenario. So you can go ahead and change the scale factor. So when we suggest the target SQL SKU, we kind of take care of those scale factor in the formulas. And then the percentile utilization, how many data points you want to capture to make this queue recommendation. So it can be 95 percentile, it can be 90 percentile or 50th percentile, which is average. So we can go, you can go ahead and select. By default, we keep the scale factor as 1 and percentile utilization as 95. With this information, you can quickly click on Start Assessment, and then the assessment gets kickstarted. This assessment module goes ahead and connects to an Oracle instance, and it does multiple kind of phases of data collection. So it collects a static data collection like, hey, what is the Oracle version? What is the Oracle edition? And so on. Then it collects the features. What are the various features which is enabled in the Oracle? Like, do you have partitioning enabled? Do you have data card enabled? And so on. And then we collect the performance data. So we connect to the Oracle. We collect some performance metadata, which is critical for the right sizing. And then we do the schema workload collection, which is a shallow discovery. So we discover the tables, the views, the code objects, the storage objects, the database size, which is primarily used to create a high-level recommendation or a migration plan for our customers. And once we collect this data, we kind of go ahead and do a quick assessment of that data and give a final recommendation. And this, every time, every 30 seconds, we go ahead and refresh this. So you kind of keep on getting the latest what's happening during behind the scenes. Now, I already have a kind of an assessment report ready. So if you have seen, like right now, we are running so many. So I already have an assessment report ready. So when you click on the assessment, so what you see is, hey, what is the suggested, like if I have to migrate this workload from Oracle to SQL? So this is an example for SQL database. And it clearly says that, yes, this Oracle data instance has 308 simple schemas which can be migrated, and it's kind of easy to migrate. So it's a green tick. You can get amber warning, or you can get a red cross, which is not recommended. Along with that, what we suggest is how many estimated hours, and in this case, it's 576 hours of code development effort, which is required to convert the schemas. And with the final one is the feature compatibility. Now, when you are trying to migrate Oracle to SQL, there are a lot of features, and we kind of do a feature migration parity and see out of score of 100, how much is the feature compatibility between the Oracle and SQL? And in this case is a pretty high of 83. And the final one is the recommended configurations. So with the current performance data, the suggestion is a 2V core and 3GB storage. And this is a kind of a high-level assessment summary, but user can go ahead and drill down further. So they can go to the database details. They can understand, okay, these are the various schemas. If you look at Oracle demo, it has 476 tables, 74 stored procedures, and so many other components, and it total will take 201 development hours to kind of do this migration. Similarly for Oracle test, it's kind of 291. So you can understand the complexity of each schema and each workload, and you can prioritize based on your requirement. Now, one thing I would like to call out, these numbers, which the estimated numbers, which we have done based on heuristic data, like we have collected a lot of previous assessment data, and we kind of created an algorithm behind the scenes. Now this can change when you do a deep dive code assessment, and the numbers can change when you start the code assessment. But these are high level figures which will help you at the pre-assessment and when you're trying to build the decision which workload to prioritize first than the later. The next is the SKU recommendation. In the SKU recommendation, we not only give you the recommended configuration, but the recommendation reasons behind it, like how much is the IOPS requirement, what's the IO latency requirement, and so on. And based on CPU, memory, IO, and storage, we go ahead and give a recommendation of the SQL SKU. And the feature compatibility is we do a one-to-one mapping wherever possible between the feature, like in this case, like active data guard, what is a suitable kind of the capability in SQL, which is always on readable secondary, and what is the migration, ease of migration, so in a scale of 0 to 5, and 5 being the ease, and the 0 is very kind of complex to migrate. And in this case, it's a 4, which is like, it's pretty fairly easy to migrate. And you can go ahead and search whichever kind of whichever feature you're interested in, like partitioning. And if I click on partitioning, you get what more in detail information, hey, what are the different partitioning capabilities and how you can migrate? Like, for example, you can use for code conversion, you can use SSMA to migrate these partitions. With all this data available, now user want to kind of reuse this data at various stages of their migration. So what we have done is you can go ahead and download this report. So when you click on download report, it actually creates an HTML report and it gives a full summary of database migration assessment report. And we collect three targets, Azure SQL managed instance, Azure SQL database, and Azure SQL VM. And we give a full report history of the entire assessment done for the given workload with a lot of extra information, like what is the suitable SKU, what is the suitable, the service tier, which is enterprise or standard edition, and a little bit of more content and information of how can you migrate it, and links to our Microsoft Docs. So that is the new kind of experience we are building for end users, and we would like to add more and more capabilities in the near future.
Awesome. Cool. This is really cool, Neel. Thanks for sharing with us. I learned a couple things myself. I didn't know you could connect to Oracle using Azure Data Studio, and certainly learned a lot about the different recommendations and how you're taking this idea of SKU recommender, which we're seeing for other migration services, to this Oracle to Azure SQL migration. So really awesome stuff. Excited to see what the team is doing here. I did have one question. Like, assuming I already have Azure Data Studio installed, how is the best way for me to get this new capabilities? Like, is it an extension? Do I have to download something else? Like, how does that setup work?
Yeah, so you go to the new marketplace, and if you search for assessment, you will get the new Oracle assessment experience. So yeah, so that's how. Okay.
Awesome. Cool. So it's just an extension. So it's really easy to get and in my existing Azure Data Studio installations.
Yeah. So you get the new extensions, like extension for Oracle, and you can go ahead and install it.
Okay. Awesome. Cool. And then one more question, Neel, you mentioned that this is really new. We're investing a lot and looking for feedback. Like, if viewers have feedback as they get started with this, where should they put that?
Yeah. So when you go to, so currently you have multiple places to give the feedback, but one of the most kind of easiest way is you have this feedback link here. So when you click, there is an email alias, and you can go ahead and reach out and send your feedback directly, or you can reach out to our, fill this information in the our community, tech community side, and provide the feedback as well.
Awesome. Cool. Thanks so much, Neel. I personally learned a lot. I think our viewers will as well, especially those trying to move off of Oracle. So it's awesome to see the investment we're making as a team in this space. To our viewers, go ahead and check the links in the description on how to get started and more information about this new extension in Azure Data Studio. And if you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, comment, and let us know what you'd like to see next. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.